things are little scary right now, very uncertain. With this lockdown and corona fear, all businesses may suffer for a longer time. Government is helping a lot for industries to start their setups, and some industries may start. But right now, my query is, it is going to be very difficult for very small SOHO businesses, specifically one personal entrepreneurship businesses, to survive and then grow in this situation.
Right.
There will be a lot of issues like how to reach people, and whether market will have funding.
Right.
And since physical communication media will be limited.
Correct.
For certain time, how to get going?
This is a paradigm shift that's going to happen. Okay, so when there's a paradigm shift, the measures have to also be equally drastic. Okay, so whatever work or whatever mindset we had in the past about using certain technologies or certain way of doing things is not going to work now. Right? So we had our personal comforts, we had our personal choices.
Right.
Okay, and those choices may not be relevant anymore.
Okay.
Okay, so therefore that change of mindset is going to be the most important factor for most individuals to make that beginning.
Okay.
Everyone is under that fear that they want what's going to happen in the next month.
Right.
Or what's going to happen in 2 months from now. Okay, we are not here to survive for 2 months.
Right.
We have a long way to go.
Right.
And therefore this is actually a very good time where you can actually sit down and draw your vision map. Because there was life before 2020, and now there is going to be life after 2020.
Right.
So it's that kind of a change. So it needs that careful planning. It's not as if some magic wand is going to be swung and things are going to restore to normal after say 6, 8, 12 months.
Right.
It's changed. First, the starting point could be talk to their customers. Understand how their customers' businesses have changed. They should also research a lot on Google, talk to friends, talk to experts in the market, and try to understand where things are heading and how they are going to be applicable to their business. So this will give them a very clear picture of how things are progressing. This will help them to create their vision map.
Yes, I agree. Very valid point. Vision map is must. There is another challenge what I feel. Okay, we are so used to meeting client personally, talking to them, understanding requirement, and during the process of maybe production, design or whatever, we meet occasionally to check whether the milestones are met, or we meet entire team to understand their requirements.
Right.
With this new situation, now physical meetings won't be possible.
Absolutely.
And I think I represent a generation where, okay, we know we are very well versed with messaging, we are very versed with audio text, we are versed with Skype, but apart from that, we are not much aware of how to use this technology to communicate.
Okay.
When we see a very young kid, college kids, they are doing a lot of things with these gadgets. We are still very scared to use them.
Okay. Okay.
So that's a like query or maybe curiosity to know that whether all these gadgets can be used in a better way in this situation.
Correct. Okay. So I take your question and try to answer it in two parts. Okay. The first part of it was like what I had said earlier, your earlier preferences or your earlier mode of working probably becomes irrelevant. So your way of functioning, of meeting clients very often, trying to understand requirements is out of the window. Okay, so at least in the near future, maybe somewhere down the line this will change. But say if you are meeting your client 10 times in 6 months, now hardly once, probably you'll have to, you'll be able to meet. So those preferences are gone. So which means now you are forced into looking at other modes of communication, whether you are comfortable or you are not.
Right.
Correct? That is number one. The second part of the question was that when you are looking at the younger generation using these devices so effectively and you are not able to do that, or you're not aware, you said, right?
Right.
I don't think it was part of awareness. I think you didn't take it seriously enough. I would like to put it that way. And to tell you, even the IT guys like us, again from your same generation, we were some of the early adopters to technology. But the way technology is changing, it's so rapidly fast that even we are feeling left behind. A 20-year-old, which you find really amazing, we all feel the same. We also feel they are like amazing on the different gadgets and apps. So that will always be like a moving target. Okay, so every generation will always start falling behind the next generation if they do not react.
Right.
Okay, so for us, it's going to be even more important that we catch up fast.
There's you won't have any options.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean, this is forced.
Right.
Yeah, if you had adopted it by choice, it would have been great. But now it's forced, so it will be slightly painful, but it's fine. That pain will give you the learning. And therefore, I feel adapting to the digital technology will be the way to go forward. Whether it's an individual business, whether it's a corporate.
Interesting.
All businesses are going to be forced into making that digital transformation.
I totally agree that the change is forced now.
Yeah.
Like if we have to survive and grow, we have to adopt new things and think in a different way.
Correct.
So can you help me and other individuals like me who are individual SOHO businesses to make their vision plan and to learn more how to communicate, maybe like devising new communication technologies. And maybe we also want to reach out to people. Okay, so what are the ways to reach out?
Correct.
So if you can help all of us with your expertise and knowledge on these topics, that will be great help.
I would be really happy to help on those fronts wherever possible. Yeah. And see, two things. One, survival. Yeah, survival is again out of question. We are not here to survive. We are here to grow.
Right.
I think that's the first mindset change that we have to make. If we are thinking of survival, we are living in fear. Okay, this is not about survival. This is about growth. Yeah. So we have to first change that mindset for growth, not survival. That's number one.
Right.
Second thing is, yes, we need to devise new ways of rebuilding and regrowing our businesses, building better communication channels, reaching out to people. Yes, and as far as digital media is concerned, there are a lot of opportunities, there are a lot of ways of doing it, easy ways of doing it, inexpensive ways of doing it.
Okay.
Yeah, exactly. The only problem is we never explored that.
Right, that's true.
Correct. So that's where the point is. So as SOHO individuals, I would like to really assure the audience here is that please don't panic. Please don't live in fear. Okay, we are here to grow, and some amazing opportunities may lie in store for your business. Only thing is we have to keep our eyes and ears open. Right. And that's where our vision plan is going to be very important. And then applying it with digital technology applying it with other ways of means of communication and the creating your business models will definitely make it a success. So if our audience has any questions, queries for us, they can definitely share, and we would love to invite you also in this session, because see, ultimately this is not a one way monologue or a dialogue based session. We want to make it a community based, yeah, because the ideas are going to come in the community, and since everyone is in the same boat, okay,
true,
whether you are a single individual business owner or a corporate, everyone is in the same problem, right? So we have to solve this problem as a group, as a community. So all the single owner or home based businesses out there can please connect with us, and let's share and discuss opportunities and ideas, and maybe you will be the next unicorn or the billion-dollar idea that's out there in the next few years.
Thanks, Amod. I'm very sure these sessions will help me and my other friends too. Some of them may like to join the session with their queries and requirements.
Oh, wow. That would be good.
So, let's talk again on this.
Yes.
Till then, stay home, stay safe.